swimming.
Show you.
I want to.
You're
show you.
I'm looking for one more volunteer. How about you with the red sleeves? Make your way on down. I'm going to have two of you stand on Bethany's right side and the other two on her left. Right on up near that habitat wall. And we are going to see the mimicry in action.
They didn't do this. Yeah, I'll try.
Okay. I'm thirsty. Oh! Baby, I'm thirsty.
I am too. I got one of them.
This will make me piss.
Half will make you piss too. Let me finish doing it, and I'll give you a water.
Program down in Florida. It's the longest running dolphin research project in the world, and thanks to them, we have a better understanding of how dolphins use their bodies in the water. Now, dolphins have three different types of fins, so we're going to take some time to look at each one of those fins right now. You will notice the pectoral fin first. Those are the two fins on either side of their body. These are important for steering in the water. Next up, we're going to see the dorsal fin. And that is that iconic triangular-shaped fin on top of their body that helps provide balance as they're swimming. And last, but certainly not least, we are going to see their tail flukes, which are the two fins located at the base of their body, important for speed and propulsion as they move. They're also handy for making new friends and giving a little wave. Now, together, these three different types of fins give the dolphins three very important things.
Speed, power, and agility. Oh, that is good.
Nice.
How about a quick round of applause for our speedy, powerful, and agile dolphins showing off those three different types of fins. And you may have noticed today quite a bit of communication going on with myself, Jamie, the care team, and the dolphins. And that's because dolphins rely heavily on communication in order to keep in touch. Now, dolphins can make a variety of noises, and we ask you to keep in mind that dolphins do not So any of the noises you're about to hear come from the blowhole on top of their head. Let's take a listen. It's 11. Yeah. In a behavior known as breaching. Now, breaching occurs when a dolphin leaps up out of the water and lands on its back, creating a loud boom. Let's see how it works.
Boom.
Here comes Allison.
Boom.
Now, make sure to listen for that large boom. Noelani is up next.
Yep, another.
And each dolphin has a unique breach. Let's give them a quick round of applause. Now, I'm curious, just by looking around here, how many of you would like a chance to play a game with a dolphin today? Go on and raise your hand.
Pissed off.
That sounds pretty fun. And you're in luck because we're about to play a game you can all participate in. This is a game invented by Noelani through that mimicry process we saw earlier. The only rule you need to know is to please remain seated. Everyone get ready to have some fun. Here comes the killer splash.
Oh, shit. We might get wet. Nah, it's just trying to get crystal. About your hunger.